Hi, I'm Alex with Splunk Education. In this video, we'll show you how to download and ingest the Splunk tutorial data into your test environment. The tutorial data file contains several types of information about the fictitious online store, Buttercup Games. It is updated daily and contains events that are timestamped for the previous 7 days. This set of data is designed to show you the features in the product, giving you the best success rate in practicing your SPL skills. Using the tutorial data also ensures that your search results are consistent, provided you'd like to follow the steps in the search tutorial found at docs.splunk.com. This is a really great resource if you're just getting started learning Splunk. We'll begin by selecting Part 1, Getting Started, then download the tutorial files from the menu on the right. That will navigate us directly to the location where we can select Download once more to download the files to our local machine. You can use either the Splunk Cloud or Splunk Enterprise platform to ingest the data. For this demonstration, we are using Splunk Enterprise. If you don't have a Splunk test environment, check out one of our recent videos on how to install Splunk Enterprise on Linux or Windows. To ingest the data, we navigate to Settings, then Add Data. At the bottom of the screen, you'll find different options to ingest data. Upload allows a user to upload a file or archive of files to be indexed. Monitor allows a user to monitor files and directories. And Forward allows a user to forward data from one Splunk instance to another, or to a non-Splunk system. We only need to upload a static set of files, so we select Upload. Under Select Source, we click Select File and choose the zipped tutorial data we just downloaded and click Open. Selecting Next takes us to Input Settings. Under Input Settings, we can override the default settings for source type, host, and index. Because this tutorial uses a zip file, we're going to modify the host setting to assign the host values by using a portion of the path name for the files included in the zip file. We select Segment in Path and set the value to 1. Please note, by leaving the index selection as default, events will automatically be ingested to the main index. As a best practice, creating a dedicated index is recommended over using the default, as it provides greater control over data retention policies and security. For the purpose of following along with the tutorial, we are going to leave it as default and select Review. We'll confirm all our selections are correct before selecting Submit to officially add the data to our environment. We select Start Searching to see our data in the Search and Reporting app. A search is automatically run on the tutorial data source, and the results confirm the data in the tutorialdata.zip file was indexed and the events were created. You are now ready to start practicing your SPL. For getting started guides and product tips, please visit Splunk Lantern. We also suggest you check out the documentation, watch additional videos on the Splunk How-To channel, and register for courses from Splunk Education. Thanks for watching.